morning, everybody. I'm Gabriel Poveda. It's a pleasure to see so many friendly faces. Happy Constitution Day. Today, I'll be discussing how oil subsidies make competition and growth hard, if not impossible, for renewable energy. After presenting the problem, which I'm just going to dive right into, I'll discuss the two solutions and give you my creative, bold idea. So the problem is very simple. Imagine you're a renewable energy company. You have a new innovative mean of energy that you want to put on the market to sell as soon as possible. You do everything right, but for some reason, you can't build in certain areas, you can't sell in certain areas, and you're just having a tough time competing overall. You might think, oh, that's just the free market, that's just supply and demand, and in part, you'd be right. But that some reason is also oil subsidies. As a renewable energy company, you're not just competing against oil companies that are bigger than your companies or that has been around longer than your company, but you're also competing against an oil company that has millions of tax dollars up its sleeve. A good example of this problem is actually Tesla. They have to compete against car companies that have been around for a near century and car companies who have special incentives and tax credits. These special incentives and tax credits acted like oil subsidies, and because of them, Tesla had a hard time making an impact in the world of gasoline cars. As you can see here, Tesla faced big companies that have been around for a long time, and so does renewable energy. So, like Tesla faced tax credits, renewable energy companies like Southern California's Solar City face oil subsidies that make the free market unfair. The oil subsidies mean that oil companies are getting millions, and the government is picking favorites and limiting the market. Let me give you an example. The Revenue Act of 1913 allowed oil companies to write off the cost of oil and gas wells by 5%. Today, they write off 15%, which means over the years, oil companies have gotten billions in US tax dollars. That's only one example. But you can look at the federal tax code, and you'll see that there are these broad exemptions and deductions that mean oil companies are paying far less than the standard 35% corporate rate. The problem for renewable energy gets worse. On the local level, there are groups like ALEC and American for Prosperity who spend millions of dollars on council member elections and state congresses. They pass intrusive ordinances that prohibit, for example, wind plant development, solar installation, and the construction of new energy infrastructure. Groups like them actually used to forbid Tesla from selling cars in their state. Tesla made it big because it had a new innovative product that I would love to drive one day. But it also made it big because it was given a $500 million loan by the Department of Energy in 2009. With this loan, Tesla had a counterbalance to the millions of dollars the American government already gave to car companies. Tesla needed the government to give them a hand so that they could get their head in the game, so that they had the same special interests that the car companies did. In the case of renewable energy, the government needs to do something so that they can get their head in the game and put up a good game. That's where my idea comes in. For innovative energy to thrive, you're left with two solutions. You can either have the government give millions to renewable energy, subsidize it, or you could create a level playing field for all energy industries. The US government should eliminate the special interest that the fossil fuel industry gets. In doing so, it'll allow renewable energy to compete and incentivize oil companies to innovate, to move towards cheaper, cleaner alternative means of energy. By giving big oil tax breaks, we are getting rid of innovation. We are rewarding them for complacency because they have basically no competition. Here's a connection I need you guys to make. Without competition, there is no free market. Without the free market, the consumer doesn't get the best product. Our country thrives off of the free market. It's supply and demand that works for us. The company with the best, cheapest product gets the consumer. So what do the other companies do? They make even better and cheaper products. That's why your iPhone gets better every time a new one comes out. That's why your Android gets better every time a new one comes out. That's what competition, the free market, gets us. A better product. Once Tesla was allowed to compete, it sparked innovation in the car industry that gets us safer, cleaner, more fuel-efficient cars. Once renewable energy is allowed to compete, it'll do the same and it'll spark innovation. Here's why. The cost of solar has dropped by 80% in the last 10 years, and on the global stage, it'll account for half the world's energy supply by 2030. The renewable energy workforce consists of two-thirds uneducated workers, which means that down to earth, renewable energy fights fights poverty domestically and makes your bottom dollar lower. Rebuilding our country's infrastructure is a job that can't be exported. It's the job of a growing industry, and it's the job of the future. China leads us in renewable energy development. They're bringing in billions of dollars of investment in innovation when that innovation could happen right here at home. Here in Houston is innovation. NRG CEO David Crane cites renewables as a market worth $1 trillion. Under his directive, NRG moves jobs from petroleum to renewable energy. They don't lose jobs. It's the Republican Green Tea Party that goes to local legislatures and fights for a fair energy system. It was Ronald Reagan who said, under his tax proposal, that those who earn their wealth in the fossil fuel industry should be subject to the same taxes as the rest of us. Innovation is where left meets right. It's where conservatives agree with liberals. For conservatives, we need fair capitalism, a free market so that there is no government overreach. For liberals, we need a renewable energy boom so that we can perhaps kick off the fight against climate change and save this one planet we all share. I look forward to your questions, and I thank you all very much for your time.
So, as we all know, essentially, the Woodlands was built around petroleum companies. How do you think that your idea will affect the livelihood of your high school peers in terms of changing?
Well, I'm glad you asked that. I'm glad you asked that because what I've seen is that I'm a member of the Climate Reality Project, and I went to a training this summer in Houston. And when I went there, I was amazed to find that not only is Houston the energy capital of the world, but it's also the renewable energy capital of the world. If we can go back to this slide, you'll see that all of these are renewable energy companies that are based right here in Houston. There's a lot of innovation and job opportunity for my peers in these companies. And also, like NRG, which is a petroleum company that's based right here in Houston, they have a bunch of new directives that are aimed towards moving towards renewable energy, different types of, projects that they can do.
So, aren't oil subsidies favorable to regular people in terms of, you know, the amount of pocket money they have, or just?
I'm glad you asked that, because when you look at, for example, the oil subsidies that were put in place under the Carter administration, they helped alleviate the gas prices on American families for a brief amount of time. But afterwards, what happened is that the American government keeps caving in to these oil subsidies that are demanded by the petroleum companies. So over the years, we're just giving more and more money to these petroleum companies when what they really need to do is innovate and move towards cheaper ways of being more efficient for the American households.
All right, thank you very much.